Sure. The situation I'd like to talk about is one in which I'd been hired along with one other person by two university departments to develop an application for a program that was going to be jointly held by both departments. Working with a small advisory group of faculty from both departments, we had about 6 weeks to put together a 90-page proposal. But I'm going to focus on just one aspect of that work, which was a series of interviews we conducted with faculty in the departments proposing the new program. There was, let's say, a diversity of viewpoints among the faculty on the value of the proposed program. And so part of our job was to interview everyone in both departments in order to get their input on the project. The advisory team also saw this as an opportunity to try and increase the willingness of both departments to support the proposal. Having strong buy-in on the proposal was critical to its success as it moved through the approvals processes. We were warned that these might not always be easy conversations. My colleague and I then prepared for the interviews by doing background research on each of the faculty members to be interviewed so we knew a little bit about their research going in. We also prepared a short description of the proposed project that was okayed by our advisory group so that we were clear about what the team we were working with saw as the key advantages and opportunities of the proposed program. We decided in the end to go into each interview pretending we had heard nothing about the tension around the lead up to this proposal and just to see where things went. So we led each interview with some questions to the faculty member about their research and then segued into asking them how they thought this research could be served by the new program. We tended in the end to avoid talking about the advantages our committee saw in the program and instead left it open to the interviewee to envision the program in their own way. We did meet with some pushback and we recorded that feedback, but we also had a lot of great conversations about the future possibilities for research jointly developed between university departments. I think it helped that we were seen as a neutral third party by both departments. As we developed our proposal, we were able to draw on a lot of the ideas and interests that we gleaned from these interviews. So even though not everyone's dreams and ambitions for the programs could be realized, people could see themselves in it. The interviews, which were initially assigned to us as maybe a bit of a PR gesture, turned out to be one of the crucial sources we drew on to create a compelling proposal. We managed to put the proposal together on deadline, and it was approved by both departments quickly and easily. Personally, the process of doing the interviews taught me the value of approaching people without assuming a particular reaction from them. And I learned a lot about how to listen well to a variety of viewpoints and how to draw on that diversity to shape a strong and compelling case.